G'day, Hans here. Now, if you like animals of all shapes and sizes, I'm talking dogs, cats, fish, lizards, whatever, maybe you've thought about being a vet. And today, thanks to Student Edge, we're going to get inside a real vet clinic and find out just what it's all about. Come on. For people who love animals, working with them might seem like the most logical career in the world. But there are heaps of other reasons that someone might make a great vet. Today, Dr. Kathy Stark is going to help explain what being a vet is all about.
Hi, I'm Hans.
Hi, Dr. Kathy, how are you?
Great, Doc. Hey, I've got a couple of questions about being a vet. Can you help me out?
Yeah, sure. I'll come out the back and we'll have a chat.
Let's do it.
So, Hans, what did you want to talk to me about?
I want to talk about everything, Doc. Okay. But I guess we should probably start with why you wanted to become a vet.
I guess I was lucky because I always wanted to be a vet from a very young age. I grew up with lots of animals.
But of course, it's not just about animals. Obviously, you are helping people as well. Talk to me about that.
Yeah, that's actually a part of the job that most people don't realise is that, and I think even veterinary graduates don't realise that, is that it's not just about helping animals. There is a lot of work we do in helping people, allaying their fears when they've got a sick pet, helping them to feel like the responsibility is not all on their shoulders.
So I guess the job is incredibly broad. Give me the truth about it. What sort of things are you going to have to do as a vet?
I guess there's two main areas to what we do. One of them is consulting, which means that's when the people bring their animal in to us and say, you know, Fluffy's got a sore tail and we have to examine the animal and formulate a plan of what might be wrong with it. Maybe take an x-ray or take a blood test or, you know, there's lots of things we do.
But that's the easy bit.
That's the easy bit. And usually at lunchtime we start to do surgery, which means operating on animals. Sometimes we do desexings where we sterilise animals. We do dentistry, we pull teeth out of animals.
So I guess the main thing is, if you're going to want to be a vet, you are going to see some blood.
Yes.
It's going to happen.
Yes, you are going to see some blood. And a lot of what we do is not very pretty. Mm-hmm. Pulling teeth out is not a very nice job. Sometimes we have to operate on not very nice parts of the animal's body.
Yes, putting thermometers in.
Yes, thermometers.
Yep, got it. All right, Doc, it's down to that time. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
For the three questions, because I need you to give us the edge.
Okay.
All right, first question is, how do I become a vet?
If you want to become a vet, you need, if you're at school, you need to decide, probably when you're choosing your subjects for year 11 and 12, you need to do English, that's a prerequisite. You're recommended to do maths and chemistry and biology, that's helpful. You need to do pretty well at school to be a vet. The entrance ATAR score, in, if you're doing it in Western Australia, is quite high. I think for this year it's about 97.5.
Oh, wow.
So, and it is quite tough. They don't take a lot of students, about 30 school students take.
So once you finish school and you study the right subjects, then what?
Yep, well if you've got enough marks to get in, then you can apply to Murdoch University, which is the only place you can do it in Perth. If you want to do it and you're in another part of Australia, there are schools in Melbourne, Sydney, Brisbane and Adelaide. So that's a possibility.
And then you study veterinary science, is
Absolutely.
That what the course is?
Yeah.
And the last question is, if you could have done one thing differently, but still end up exactly where you are today, what would you have done better?
I didn't do work experience as a student, and I think that's really essential for anybody that wants to consider being a vet. The way to go about that probably is just to go to your local practice and ask them if you could help out, maybe on a Saturday or during the week to get some experience, so you know what you're up for.
Right. Well, thank you so much for talking to us and giving us the details. Before I go, I have to ask, is that normal?
Oh. I'd be worried about that.
Should I?
Yeah, I think you need to go and see a doctor.
Well, can you help me out?
Well, I've got one of these.
Doctor says I've got to stop licking myself. Anyway, look, if you want some more information, you've got to get onto studentedge.com.au, and if you're really serious about being a vet, get down to your local clinic and start getting some experience. I'll get that.